Hello everyone and welcome to day two of our How to Be Endo-Free Challenge. Today we are going to talk all about inflammation, because the big thing you have to know is that endo is inflammatory illness. Doctors don't really talk much about it, and they should, because they're going to give you a lot of inflammatory tablets, but they're not going to tell you that you can reverse inflammation naturally. So what you will get after today's our meeting is that you will be able to know and understand which foods are highly inflammatory and what they do to your body and how they contribute to your illness, and you will be able to know which foods to eliminate in order to feel better and get rid of the bloating, all the horrible cramps, all the pain, all the PMS. It's all not normal and can literally go away if you implement a few things. So you know all my journey from yesterday. You know that I used to have endometriosis. I was diagnosed with endometriosis 4, because it's 4 stages that spread absolutely everywhere, to my lungs, you know, to my intestines, all over my ovaries, absolutely everywhere. And I've been told it's impossible to get better, and I believe it for 20 years. I am 5th year endo-free, absolutely zero symptoms. I'm not having any surgery. I'm not taking any medicine whatsoever. So I managed to put it into remission naturally. So let's start from talking about the things which you have to avoid. First thing which is very highly inflammatory is the coffee. And I was addicted to the coffee. Like, I literally love coffee. I had to have a coffee 3 times a day, in the morning, then about 12 p.m. and then, you know, when my energy crashed, about 3 p.m. And I remember when I was giving up the coffee, I did it on the graveyard shift, which is 12-hour shift. And that was the worst thing I could possibly do, because I just feel so much like crap. So if you think that giving up the coffee, it makes you a little bit anxious, this is actually the best thing to give up from now on, because it just means that you're addicted and nothing is stronger than you. No addiction, seriously. So why the coffee is so bad? Many researchers says that coffee is good for you, but you know, these kind of researchers are very likely sponsored by the coffee industry. So before believing any research, just please make sure by who it's conducted, because you're gonna you know, very likely see that the researchers which are talking, for example, good about the wine, they are funded by the wine industry. And it's just very, very common practice for the lobbies to pay the scientists to actually conduct the researches in their favor. So just always check by who those researches I make. Actually, coffee, I think, is very clever drug, because it's accessible for everyone. It's cheap. It's socially acceptable. It's mean like everyone does it. And it disturbs our deep sleep, which means we don't have enough time to recover and feel better. But then, you know, we wake up tired and we have to get another cup of coffee, and it just keeps us addicted. How absolutely brilliant drug is that? You know, it affects your deep sleep level, and we are healing in the deep sleep, okay? There are a lot of apps those days which are measuring your deep sleep level, so go ahead and download one of them and just check, because sometimes we're sleeping 8 hours, but in our deep sleep is actually 20 minutes, and it's not enough for our body to recover. Research actually shows the link between coffee and the formation of ovarian cyst. Red bells, red bells, red bells, everyone. And it's very highly inflammatory. So first thing you have to do is give up the coffee. Another thing to absolutely give up and forget about it is refined sugar. And we are all addicts. We are all addicted of refined sugar. And it makes it very difficult, because we human need the sugar as the source of energy. Okay, not artificial sugar, but we do need sugar. We are wired to remember where the sugar is. So if you have a children and they always can find the sweets you are hiding, it's because they're wired to remember. And we also eat the sugar in one go. We are wired this way, because when our ancestors was roaming savannas, they saw, for example, beautiful berries, they didn't think like, oh, I'm gonna eat a little bit today, and then in 2 weeks when I came back, maybe I would eat the rest of it. No, they just been sitting there next to the bush, eating absolutely everything on one go. And the same with honey. When our ancestors saw the big honey, they just cut it off and eat as much as they could, you know, and took the rest, because we cannot leave sugar for later. Because one day our survival was literally depending of the resources of the sugar. And sugar is very highly inflammatory, and it's increased the PMS symptoms, which is never ending cycle, because you're eating sweets to feel a little bit better, but it actually makes your PMS worse. And we shouldn't be eating sugar all the time. We have some amazing, very smart tool called pancreas, which are, help us metabolize the sugar. But we shouldn't be metabolizing sugar all the time. And in nature, like for example, in winter times, there are a period of times when we don't just lack the sugar. Because, you know, when there is the snow, there is not enough the sugar. So our pancreas are working. But now in modern day, we are literally overfloating our pancreas, and we're not giving them any break to metabolize any excess sugar. So this thing you have to literally avoid, refined sugar, okay? And I'm gonna link in the comment section, I'm gonna link all the YouTube videos so you can watch every single one in depth. And also, if you need to know which sugar is natural and which one is artificial, I've got this special checklist created especially for you. So just let me know. I'm gonna drop my email as well, okay? Another thing which we are removing is the gluten. It's basically highly inflammatory and contributing to your bloating. And the last two things to remove is the processed food. So everything that requires processing in the production. So it's, for example, processed meat, cookies, pastries, cakes, ready meals, fast food, bread, cheeses, processed oils. They are literally increasing your inflammation and contributing to your endometriosis. Red meat is especially dangerous as one of the processed meat. And it's scientifically proven that the girls who are consuming a lot of red meat are more likely of the risk of endometriosis, actually 56% higher risk, which is mind-blowing. It's messing up with your hormones and increase the estrogen level. So please consider to cut it or to become vegetarian. I'm pescatarian, which means I eat fishes, but I don't eat any other meat. So this is what you need to know. Endo is inflammatory illness. The moment when you get rid of chronic inflammation will be the moment when you get rid of all your bad symptoms. And all things such as bloating, such as bad PMS, such as chronic pain, you know, constant pain, all this thing will go away, girl, if your body will come back to the state of normality instead of state of being constantly inflamed. And you can 100% do it, okay? So please watch the YouTube playlist, things to remove, and start to removing them one by one. I will see you tomorrow, because tomorrow we are going to talk about the hormones. Endo is also a hormonal disorder. That means that your estrogen level are too high. And tomorrow I'm gonna tell you how to decrease estrogen naturally and which cosmetics are messing up with your hormones. So keep on watching. I love you so much and see you tomorrow. Bye.